Hi everyone, it's me, your Madhya sir. It's my pleasure to be here to explain about today's topic. It is a very interesting topic, of course, that is none other than a topic Africa. My students, Africa. See, this poem is composed, written, published by a person, David Diop. David Diop. Actually, who is he? Why he wanted to write only about Africa? He could have also written about some other country too. Why he wanted to write only about Africa? He could have also written about some other nations too, right? Why did he write? You mean, see students, obviously, besides being human beings, we all have a love, concern, affection towards mother, mother tongue, motherland, and also the place which gives us food, shelter, so and so. That will be human tendency, even of course we must have that, then only we are said to be as human beings. If not, we are not even said to be as animals too. We should love our mother, motherland, birthplace, and mother tongue. One who doesn't respect these all is not at all said to be as a human being, but said to be as a animal. Okay students, now you, David Diop, really this man, one who has written about Africa, finally same poem, I will also tell you that, see students here, David Diop is a man, a revolutionary poet, one who is very famous and well known for to create awareness among the people about a country. This is one of his best poems, whereas he encouraged, he make the people to indulge, you mean to participate in the freedom movement, to send the people out who were ruling that country. About that is the strength, stamina, and the people when they were not knowing their plus, minus and everything. This is the first man, one who had come to create the awareness among the people and to store their strength and to remind them that what they are and how strength they are and how strong they are, and to send the people out, the people who are ruling them. That is the main agenda of this Diop. So he has written this Africa poem. Of course, you have understood the title Africa. You could remember very well that soon after Africa name, who will come to our mind? On and only a person who? South African Gandhi. Who is he? He is only none other than Nelson Mandela. Of course, you may know very well. A person, one who said a popular saying in English that education is the only weapon which can change the entire world. You mean the only one weapon to change the world? Which is the only weapon? Education is the only the weapon which can change the world. This is the popular saying which was said by Nelson Mandela. That, and not only that, he was a warm man, one who fought against the people who were ruling the country, and also one who abolished slavery like Abraham Lincoln in USA. The same, so that he had become very popular. He was not only a freedom fighter but also an ex-president of South Africa. So we will remember him first. So here, see students, you know very well that, just I have told you the example, a person, one who had come from this Africa. I have also told you about this David Diop was a man, one who was, actually this poem was written by Diop, published and composed by him. Why in the sense, when the country was ruled by other country people for their own personal gain, when this country remained idle, silent, and who had faith in their rule, one who could not question and one who could not fight against them, to create awareness among them and to make them to rag against or to fight against them and to send them out. That is the poem he has written at that time, to motivate the people, to encourage the people to fight against them and to show them that how strong strength they are. Okay, say come to page number 31. I hope you all are having the time. Come to page number 37. Poem Africa. 37, page number. Keep your pencils, Ready? Let us start the poem. Shall I, students? Once I recite a poem, you also try at home. You also recite at home. Then you will understand. Shall I start? Are you ready? I'm ready. Say, Africa. My Africa. Africa of proud warriors in ancestral savannas. Africa of whom my grandmother sings always. On the bank of the distant river, I have never known you, but your blood flows in my body. Your beautiful black blood that irrigates the fields, that blood of your sweat, the sweat of your work. Page number 38, turn the page. The work of your slavery, the slavery of your children. Africa, please tell me, Africa. Is this you? This back that is bent? This back that breaks under the weight of humiliation? This back trembling with the red scars and saying yes to the whim under the sun? You mean midday sun. But a grave voice answers me, impetuous sun, that tree young and strong, that tree there. In splendid loneliness amidst white and faded flowers, that's Africa. That's Africa. Your Africa. That goes again patiently, obstinately, and its fruits gradually acquires the bitter taste of liberty. This is the poem, students. I hope you have understood. Now, come back to the poem. Let us see line by line and we see the theme of this poem. Why did he write? Why did he write same poem? Okay, students. Now, already I have told you the scenario when this poem was written. This poem was written actually when the country was ruled by other country people for their economic gain purpose. When that country was looted by others. But one thing here, very interesting thing is, this David Diop, he was not an African. Though he had written the poem, what is the secret of this poem? Okay, now same poem, if I recite, see, you know very well that we will be telling and we will also be knowing and we everyone will understand. Only on August 15th we will be telling you, India is ruled by British people 200 years. Then we have sent them out, Gandhiji, Nehruji, Netaji, that, these, many things we say. And they were the people who fought against the British people and who had brought the independence. Not brought, we have taken independence. Independence was not given by British was. We have kicked them like anything and we have taken independence, that everyone knows. You mean in that group, there were many groups. You mean seniors, juniors, revolutionaries. Their main all three members' agenda to kick the British people and to take home independence from them. Finally, it was taken. Then in 1947, August 15th, we have kicked them and they ran from our country. During that time, many of our poets had written many newspapers, many poems, many magazines to create awareness among the people to fight against the British people and to burn the foreign goods and to use only Swadeshi goods. Same way, Diop, also a man, one who had written this poem to encourage the freedom fighters who were in South Africa to fight against the people who were ruling them. You mean colonialism? Colonialism is nothing but one country has come to rule, you mean capture, to take that complete country under their control for their economic gain purpose is called as colonialism. That you might have already studied in social science, of course. Then in the same way, this Diop, what all he is telling. But one thing, he is not from Africa. Again and again I am telling, though he had written as if he is from Africa, he was having lot of love, passion and even concern, mercy, pity and love over this country and towards this country, because in his ancestors are from Africa. He was not from Africa, he was in France. Okay, students. Now let us read about this David Diop. Once I will read. If you come to page number 41, about few lines are given about him. David Mandesi Diop, one who was born in 1927, was a revolutionary African poet, one who was born in France to the parents of African descent. He lived in France through his childhood and visited Africa in 1950. About his poems highlighted the problems of Africa and brought about the colonialism and gave a message to the Africans to bring about the changes and freedom. He was known for his involvement in the intrigued movement in the France, a movement started by the black writers and artists protesting against the French colonialism and its effects on the African culture and values. His views and feelings were published in the Presence African and in his book of poems, Cups de Pilon, which was published in 1956. Diop died at the age of 33 in a plane crash. Okay, students, he was born in 1927. Then in 1956, his books were published. Then when his age was 33 years, he passed away in the plane crash. But when in 1950 he visited Africa, then he has noticed the things what was happening in the Africa. But Africa culture and values, ethics, virtues and everything has been declining. He could not able to tolerate that. So by remembering that, he had written this poem to create awareness among the people to fight against them. Okay, students, now you come to the poem. Let's go to the poem. If you come to page number 37, see, at first line you see, Africa, my Africa, you mean, he says he is conveying a message through his patriotism. So that is what, so the, it shows the patriotism of the poet. Then it is actually written in the drastic situation. So Africa of proud warriors in ancestral savannas, you mean? So Africa, my Africa, Africa proud of my ancestors who fought against the people for the independence, you mean? His ancestors were the warriors who lived in Africa, the people who fought against the people who were fighting and who were ruling in Africa, and they have lost their ancestors. That is what he is telling, that Africa proud of your warriors, Africa of whom my grandmother sings. I was not knowing anything else about you, about you refer to whom? Africa. I have never come to know about you anything else. How come I came to know about you? I came to know through my grandmother singing. You mean, she often sings a songs based on Africa. Through that singing songs, I understood and I came to know, and I have come to know the little information or the knowledge about Africa. On the bank of the distant river, you mean, I have never known you. You mean, I have never known you. I don't know anything else about you. I came to know through my grandmother singing. But the place which is far away from the area where we are, Africa, dear Africa, you proud of your warriors, I don't know anything else about you. I have come to know through my grandmother singing. And even, see, next, but your blood flows in my vein. See, I don't know about you, but one thing you keep it in mind. I am telling you, I am very happy and I am very much delighted to tell you that I might have not being brought up in Africa, but your blood is in my body. You mean Africa blood it is. Your beautiful black blood that irrigates the field. You mean black blood is nothing but blood is not black color here. It is significant, it symbolizes the color of Africans. You mean it makes us, by working very hard than others, to irrigate the field. Then what happens? The blood of your sweat. You mean the sweat what we have here, that is Africans' blood sweat. And even the sweat of your work, that is the work which actually shows that how African we are. You mean it symbolizes African hard work. Okay, students. Then again, come to page number 38. Turn the page. The work of your slavery. You mean the work of your slavery. You all are treated like a slaves. That could not be forgotten. Then the slavery of your children. You see, still your children also are working like a slaves. Then Africa. Tell me, Africa. See, in the first lines he says that Africa, my Africa, I don't know about you, Africa. Please, you be proud about my ancestors, and I also feel very proud about my ancestors that they are from Africa, and I have never known anything else about you. I have come to know about you only through my grandmother singing. And see, Africa, one thing I would like to tell you, and I am very much pleased, and I am very happy to say that I am not from Africa, but African blood is in my body, and it shows that how our African blood sweat is, how hard worker we are, and how work you are, and even how you people worked as slaves, and even how your children are working as slaves. That all, please, Africa, you tell me about that, Africa. Then again in the next lines, students, he questions whom? Africa. Is this you? You refer to whom here? Africa. Is this you? Who? That back is already bent. You mean back is bent in the sense here, not the back what actually we have. So when we are actually tired, what will happen? Okay, we get back pain, or when we travel more, or when we work more, we people, we get tired of that situation. In the same way, see, Africa, is this you? You mean, is this you, one who ruled by these fools? You are already being bent. You mean they looted you. That is what it refers. It back is nothing but the tired of the situation expresses, conveys by the poet. This back that breaks under the weight of humiliation. You mean already your back is being bent because of ill-treated people. You mean the people, they are harassing, torturing, troubling, irritating, and even punishing you people, making use of you people like anything. For these all situations, your back is already bent. This is only you. Is this you only, Africa? This back trembling with red scars. What happened? Because of all this trouble, situations, and even harassment, problems, and even these all circumstances made you to get the red scars on your back. You mean already our people are wounded by all this harassment by the people who were ruling them. Then, and saying yes to the whip. Whip in the sense, you know, students, it is a long rope which is used by the people to punish themselves or to punish others. Okay, you mean, though this much has been happening, you mean these all the things are being done by the other people who had come from other place to rule us and to loot you. Though you are being looted in all this, still you are saying yes. What a patience you have. What a ocean of patience you have. Still you are ready to get the punishment through weep under the midday sun. What a greatness of your greatness of you. But though you may be ready for everything to get the punishment from others and to be looted and to be punished and to be troubled and to be irritated and whatever, but a grave voice answers me. Grave voice means your courageous, brave voice. Brave and serious voice is answering me. Who is that serious voice? From where that serious voice? That serious voice is none other than from the young people. You mean impetus son? You mean that tree, young and strong, that tree there. You mean he says that the people are ready without taking any decision, without thinking anything, they are ready to participate and to warn the people who are already troubling our country. That is only the tree. Tree refers to the young people here. You mean, I heard Africa, please you tell me Africa, all this about situation. But he is telling, I know you are ready to face everything, but you are not ready to react. At the same time, I have heard young people voice which is answering me. Tree refers to young people. They are strong, strength enough, still they are standing. The tree is there. Tree means that young people are there in splendid loneliness amidst white and faded flowers. That is Africa, your Africa. But that tree, you mean young people, where they are in between the people who are white amid in the sense mid, you mean middle. They are in the middle of the white and faded flowers. Faded flowers is nothing but the people who are actually controlling Africa before the before it is ruled by some other country people. You mean the actual rulers who are equally to the sick, who are actually become sick, who are ruling, who are controlling Africa. Between those people, these young people are in the middle. That is Africa. You mean between the people who are actually ruling Africa, who are actually some other country and who are ruling Africa, and between these young, between these two people, the young people are there to question and to take the freedom from them. That is Africa. Africa, that is Africa, your Africa. You mean that grows again patiently, obstinately. You mean still these all may happen, still the nation grows again like anything, and its fruit gradually acquires the bitter taste of liberty. You mean whatever the situation it may happen, but gradually it grows, it develops, improves like anything. Finally, it gets, it fruits, that is the bitter taste of liberty. Liberty means freedom. You mean, finally, we reach, we get independence. We take freedom from them. So students, I hope you have understood. Again, I repeat the poem, you see. This poem was being composed by David Diop. This was written to encourage the young people against colonialism, which was happening in Africa, and whereas the culture of Africans and the values, virtues, ethics were have been declining. At that time, this poem was being written by him. He was not from Africa, but his blood from Africa. You mean his ancestors were from where? Africa. That is what he is telling. I don't know that much about you, Africa. I have come to know about, you know, you through my grandmother singing, and even I don't know much more about you. But one thing I am very much delighted to tell you, that my body is not from Africa, but there is a blood in my body that is from Africa. That blood flows in my body is African blood. Then it shows that how Africans hard workers, and it symbolizes that how we people work better than others. And even still, in the second few lines, he explains that how the people are treated in that country. You are working like a slave. So your children are working like a slaves, but you are punished, irritated, tortured. You are looted, though you are ready to take. Still, you are ready to be looted. You are having that much ocean of patience, Africa. But in between all these situations, still there is a tree. Young people are there to stand with the strength and the lot of, you know, effort, and with the enough strength to fight against them, to enjoy their fruit at last. That is, fruit is none other than freedom. So these lines are being conveyed by David Diop about Africa. Okay, students, again, if you have any doubts regarding this David Diop poem, you mean Africa, it will be explained in another class. See, this also I would like to tell you, I also read this Africa poem in the name of India. This poem, it, which suits to our country also, because India is also one of the countries which was ruled by British people. So this poem suits to our India also. See students, I read again. India, my India, India of proud warriors in ancestral savannas, India of whom my grandmother sings on the bank of the distant river. I have never known you, but your blood flows in my body. Your beautiful blood that irrigates the field, that blood of your sweat, the sweat of your work, the work of your slavery, the slavery of your children. India, tell me India, is this you? Your back is already being bent. This back that breaks the weight of humiliation. You mean you are tortured by like anything by the British people? That all stories, if you come to know, you will be understood, and it will be explained in the class also. Then this back trembling with red scars and saying yes still to the weep under the midday sun. But a grave voice answers me, impetuous son, that young people, you mean tree, there are, it is there, that tree is there. In splendid loneliness amid white and faded people, you mean flowers, that is India, your India, you mean my India, that grows again patiently, obstinately, and its fruits gradually acquired the bitter taste of freedom. It is already taken. So because in which situation this poem was written, you know, that situation was being faced by India too. So that is what I am telling you, this poem suits to our motherland also, students. Okay, though besides, even I wanted to conclude this poem with, but one thing we have to keep it in mind, that though many country people have looted and ruled us, still if it is there any country standing and fighting in all the fields and getting success in all the fields better than all other countries and to be praised by all other country people in the world, that is own and only country, none other than only India, no other country. You mean all the country people looted, Dutch, French, British, all the people looted, still it is standing to fight and to show in all the fields that what we are, and even the people, we are showing our tradition, culture and everything else to the Arakan people, and we are also teaching them that how they have to be behaved and how they have to be treated, and even these all the things, even other country, we remain as a model, as an inspiration to all of us. That is the greatness of our country. Okay students, okay, I conclude this poem, and if you have any further details, that will be explained in next class. Students, I hope you all have understood the poem. See you in next class. Thank you.